We all know that a capacitor allows AC but blocks DC. Let's see the reason behind this. If we connect a capacitor to a DC power supply, it will begin to charge. Because of this, there will be a current flow in the circuit. But once the capacitor is fully charged, there will be no space for further charges and there will be no current flow. When we connect this charged capacitor to a load, the capacitor will begin to discharge. During this process, there will be a current flow. So we can conclude that there is current flow in the circuit whenever the capacitor is charging and discharging. So this is why capacitor blocks DC. It actually has some current flow initially, but once capacitor is fully charged, it can no longer allow any current flow in the circuit. Let's see the case of AC. Let us consider an AC power source. This is its waveform. For our convenience, let us divide this waveform into four parts. In this first part, the voltage rises from 0 to its maximum value. During this process, the capacitor will begin to charge from 0 to its maximum value. And in the second part, the voltage drops from maximum to its minimum value. And during this process, the capacitor will begin to discharge the stored charges. So there is a continuous charging and discharging happening in there. Let's get to the third part. In this part also, the capacitor will begin to charge from 0 to its maximum value, but in the opposite direction. And again, these stored charges will be released. So with an AC power supply, a capacitor constantly charges and discharges. And because of this, there is a constant oscillation of charges between its plates. So a capacitor with an AC power supply will have charges oscillating between its plates. And this constitutes a current flow.